For this Rockler Band Wood Challenge, I was quite excited and came up with an interesting stool design that I have never seen before, made from wood. And if you are wondering why, then you will find out in this video. First, I went to my favorite local lumber store to get some fine pieces of hard maple. I let them cut the boards in two in order to fit in my car and bring it home. I went to my local makerspace, the Kaasfabriek, in Alkmaar, the Netherlands, which can be translated as cheese factory, because Alkmaar has a famous Dutch cheese market. But we do not make any cheese in this makerspace. Here I can use the CNC router to make the parts for the jig in order to bend the pieces of maple for the legs of the stool in the right shape. And no, this is not inspired on the male version of a Christmas angel tree decoration. I took home all the parts and sanded them. I used a long central dowel to get the parts all lined up. Then I glued and nailed the parts together with some smaller dowels in order to get the angle between the parts consistent. Now the jig was ready, I had to make a steam box. For this I bought an egg cooker for just 2 euro on the local flea market. It was a bit rusty, but still perfect for this project. I made the steam box from some leftover pine panels I had laying around. Because the maple strips are not that large, I could deal with a steam box outer dimension of 10 by 10 centimeters, which is about 4 by 4 inch, and a length of a little less than 1.5 meter, which is about 55 inch. For the part between the cap of the egg cooker and the steam box, I used the CNC router to make a perfect fit connection. The laser cutter was very helpful to make the right size hole in the cap of the egg cooker. When the steam box was ready, I could start making the maple strips. I cut the strips 6 mm thick, which is about 1/4 of an inch, For each leg I needed 5 strips, and because the stool has 3 legs, I needed in total of 15 strips. But I expected some failure, so I made some extra. In the end I had to make 7 extra strips for this project. Now I was ready to steam the first strip of wood. I left the strip for at least half an hour in the steam box. And because the egg cooker has not a large capacity, I had to refill with water only once during this half hour of steaming. And when the first strip of wood came out of the steam box, the big question was of course, will it bend? And it did. But the first strip took quite some time to clamp it to the jig. Some of the strips did snap. Further along, I made some improvements with C-shaped pieces of plywood in order to clamp the strips quicker to the jig, and that worked well. After about an hour of clamping in the jig, I needed the jig for the next steamed strip. Taking the strip out of the jig, it was cooled down but still a little bit wet. And in order to keep it in the right shape, I clamped it on a piece of wood and let it dry overnight. In the first place, I thought I could glue and clamp all 5 pieces of maple strips for one leg at once. But the reality was that there was too much tension in the strips. So I ended up gluing all the strips one by one. I was glad that I had enough clamps for this, but looking at the footage of this first part leg glue up, I needed more than 50 minutes to get all the clamps on. After a few glue ups, this process went smoother, quicker and less stressful. In the meantime, I went back to the makerspace and cutting the parts for the seat and bottom ring. For better grain orientation, I made the seat out of 12 segments, of which 3 has a cutout for each leg. Each segment was holed in the base material with some tabs, but during sanding off these tabs and during gluing them together, I realized that this was not a very good idea, because the seams did not join perfectly and there were still some gaps between the segments. In the meantime, I think this was lesson 28 learned from this project. Thank you. I had sanded the legs and routed the seat for the last time, I could start assembling. And up to this moment, I still did not have a clue how to do this. I made a jig to hold the seat and the bottom ring in the right position. But after 2 hours of trying to make the first leg fit, I realized that the shape of the leg was not the same as the jig. At this point, I decided that my initial concept would not work for this complex geometry. So to make the best out of it, I decided to attach the legs at the outside of the seat and the bottom ring. I have tried to sit on it, but not with my full weight. It was too sketchy and it made a lot of noise. So to me this project failed as a stool. But it still can be used as a lamp, plant holder or garbage bin. And although this project did not meet my expectation, I still like wood.